So welcome to this class on somatics. For those of you just joining or those of you watching at home, you will need a mat and a couple of blankets to do this class. And we're going to start the class in standing, so a brief standing scan. So if you'd like to come up in your own time. And find a position for your feet that feels natural, comfortable. And then close the eyes. And with the eyes closed, notice what is the first thing you notice about yourself. What's the first part of your body that starts talking to you? And then turn the awareness down to the feet. And let yourself rock a little forward and back, like a human pendulum. Weight settling into the heels, weight being received by the balls of the feet. And noticing maybe the solidity of the heel bone, the calcaneus, and the spreading of the balls of the feet as they receive the weight of the body, this gentle shift. And if you are a human pendulum, could you find a place of balance now where the pendulum is right in the middle, some kind of still point? And you might notice that the body is, in essence, never still. So turning your awareness to all the tiny micro oscillations that take place, what's called postural sway in anatomy terms. All of the tiny firings of your muscles and ligaments and tendons, your fascia. All the things that happen just to keep you upright, balanced. And then notice how your pelvis sits on your legs. How your rib basket sits over your pelvis. And then the position of the head, that third ball, if you like. And in between those three primary shapes, head and ribs and pelvis, is your undulating fluid spine. So notice the curves of your spine in your mind's eye. And how those curves feel, how they feel as they flow into one another, how they feel individually. Whether there's length or compression. Ease or tension. And then for a moment, as we've been doing in a lot of these classes, with the eyes still closed, orient yourself in space. Feel for the space in front and behind. The space to the right and the left. Space above. Space between you and the center of the earth. And the sort of three-dimensionality of where your skin suit meets space. And then when you're ready, open your eyes and take your skin suit for a short walk. You might not have too much space in your room. And see if anything that you noticed in your standing, see if you can map it onto your moving body. So maybe you notice something about your spine or your pelvis, your feet. How does that translate into your moving body in a very kind of general way? The ease or lack of ease in the walking today, the tension or relaxation through the spine, through the shoulders, through the arms, you're just noticing. That's the job of a somanaut. Because when we notice something, we have the ability to change it. So like Thomas Hanna said, when you sense it and feel it, you can change it. And then walk yourself back to your mat again and bring yourself into lying. So we have a standing scan, a walking scan, a lying scan. And see if you're comfortable to lie with legs long, whether that's possible. Getting a sense of the imprint of your spine and the imprint of the whole back body. And you might imagine you're lying in the sand or you've just dipped yourself in ink and you're making a big, colorful ink blot on the floor. Where do you have contact and weight, connection with the earth? And where do you have space? And that tells us a lot. Certainly over time when we learn to calibrate these scans. It's a lot of information just here, right here. And then let your head roll a few times right and left. So you're giving weight at the back of the head. And as you let the head roll, emptying out anything you don't need. Thoughts, sensations, mind chatter, emotional stuff that just isn't needed right now. In essence, anything that isn't serving you in the moment, just let it go. My meditation teacher is very fond of saying, put down the bag of rocks. And it's such an apt description for the rocks that we carry around that we don't need in the moment. Because usually the moment is safe and good, and it's all there is. So if this moment is safe and this moment is good, then we are safe and we are good. And everything is already okay. And when you're ready now, bend up your knees one by one. So you're going to take what we call constructive rest. So on the back with knees bent. And we're going to travel towards an arch and a flatten. So as you inhale, you're going to roll across the sacrum, arching the low back. And as you exhale, you're going to roll across the sacrum, flattening the low back towards the floor. And as many of you know, it's not a braced, held flatten. It's a lengthening of the back that is helped by a little bit more concentric contraction in the front. So it's a dance between front and back. Inhaling your way into an arch, exhaling your way into a flatten. And just noticing what you notice. Where is it you want to place your attention today? Is it in your front body, your back body? Is it in your bones or your muscles? And as you explore this really simple movement, knowing that you're calibrating yourself around your midline. And we do this again and again as humans. We move away from midline, we reorganize in midline. And then we use midline when we move out into twisting, into side bending, into any movement that we do. And the next time you come to neutral, so pelvis just balanced in neutral, if what we just did was 12 and 6, let's take the knees now 3 and 9. And I would encourage you just to make that a relatively small movement. So again, it's the feeling of rolling across the bones of the pelvis, being held by the bones. Sacrum to pelvic half to sacrum to pelvic half. And if you let the knees tip too far, you tend to go a little bit more into your musculature. So try staying more contained in your bones. And again, this 3-9 or east-west. And then when you're ready, put all of those four cardinal directions together to make what we call a pelvic clock. So you're going to draw 1 to 12 all the way around the pelvis. And you're trying to make your clock as circular as you can. What would that be like, this circular clock? Again, it's a moment-to-moment giving of weight and a moment-to-moment joining the dots. And then when you're ready, take your clock in the opposite direction. Again, smooth, seamless, as circular as you can make it today. And cultivating just a what Stephen Levine calls a cosmic sense of humor if your circle is not so circular. It can take quite some time to join the dots for people, literally. And then when you're ready, let the focus of that go and simply spiral in ease, right, left, or reach, or roll, or side bend, rotate, whatever you need to do now for about the next minute, minute and a half. So this full body pendiculation, full body yawning, that is such a integral part of somatics. Baking in what we call the pleasure principle. What does the body want to do that feels good and nice? And if you're yawning, make sure to let the jaw relax, release. Allow a little reverberation through your body, which is what yawning does. Tonifies all the tissues. And then find your way onto your back with one leg long and one knee bent. So the knee bent is going to be out to the side. Frog's leg style, kind of baddha konasana in yoga, half a baddha konasana. And the long leg, I've let it relax. So the toes will probably roll out in most of you. Take the hand of the bent leg, the same side as the bent leg, and place it on your inner thigh. And we're going to inhale to exhale. And on the exhale, draw the knee up towards the ceiling. So we glide short in the inner thigh muscles and then slowly let the knee travel towards the floor again. Inhale to exhale. At the end of the exhale or on the exhale, drawing the knee towards the midline, feeling with your fingers what happens in the tissue. And then releasing as slowly, slowly, slowly as you can. And as we do that, the next time we're going to add in the straight leg also rotating inwards. And then slowly releasing. So for the Manchester SECs present, this is one of our module one moves that you might like to add into your walking and hip and lower back and leg explorations. So I'm adding it in here for you. So the legs come essentially closer together. And then it's this long gliding, resisting gravity all the way out. And then let that pause at the end, changing the legs around. And just doing the bent leg side to start. Inhale to exhale, the end of the exhale, or just towards the end of it. Drawing the knee up and then slowly releasing. And you might find that naturally that straight leg starts to rotate inwards. Just notice for yourself. Also, very likely that you have some jumpy, jerky, shaky or some stutter. Adductors are generally short and weak in a lot of folks. And that can express itself in many, many ways. So as always in somatics, see if you can find the stutter and smooth it out. And that might mean you have to go through it a good few times, like ironing out a stubborn crease on a tablecloth. You might have to go back and forth across that place. One more pass, noticing for you if a straight leg wants to join in naturally. Putting the brain in the body, in this case, in the inner legs, as you release. And then slide that second leg long. And just take a moment here, feel into your pelvis. Get a sense of your low back. And then take constructive rest again. Taking your two hands behind your head, and take an arch and curl. So you're going to inhale to arch. Elbows may travel back towards the floor. Shoulder blades may also travel back. Exhale at the end of the exhale or towards the end of it, curling. And then slowly, slowly release. So that easeful, resisting gravity. It's very liquid. Your body is fluid. So can you make the releases as fluid and even the shortening phase here? What happens if you imagine yourself as more fluid than solid? Slowly releasing out each time. Do one more in your own time. Again, noticing what glides short in your front body. And then what can glide long on the release. And if we put that together with the movement that we just did, we get something like this. So take both the knees out to the side now. So this is a full flower. Feet a little bit apart so that when you pivot onto the soles of your feet, you're not having to shuffle. Inhale to arch. Exhale, drawing everything towards sort of an imaginary center. I like to think around my belly button, as if I had a puppet master or mistress that was slowly lengthening the strings away from the navel center to all six limbs, and then shortening the strings, all six limbs, towards the navel center. And could there be a little bit of timing to the movement. So you're arriving into your flower and blossoming out of your flower at the same time. And then when you come down out of the next one, sliding the legs long, arms long, notice if you need to roll your head or do anything else. And then when you're ready, take yourself onto your belly and make a pillow with your hands. So nice and long with the body. And then bending one knee and drawing these lazy circles. And again, you might imagine that you have a paintbrush in between your toes. And then channel your inner Thich Nhat Hanh and draw a beautiful Zen style circle. And changing sides. And you might notice the conversation foot to knee to hip, pubic bone, sacroiliac joint, lumbar spine. This is a great example of a little bit of movement in a lot of places. And you might already be noticing whether the front of one hip is more open on one side than the other. Do you have more or less space between the front of the groin? Again, with this light awareness. And then resting onto the top of the foot. Gently press your pubic bone down and lengthen the two legs. Slide them along the floor. And then let it go. Press the pubic bone down, lengthen the two legs, slide them along the floor, and let it go. And just notice, do that once or twice more. Notice the feeling in your low back, feeling in your pelvis. And then play with doing this movement just with a single leg. So you lengthen both, you press the pubic bone down, you lengthen one leg, let's say the right, and now lifting the leg off the floor and slowly, slowly, slowly releasing. And then melting it at the bottom. Pressing the pubic bone down, lengthening the other leg, sliding it along the floor, lifting it off a little bit. And slowly, slowly, slowly releasing. And play with that a few times each side. Again, the conversation between your legs and your spine, your pelvis. And when you've got a handle on single legs, go back to double, press, lengthen, and now do a lift with both legs. So Shalabhasana style. And slowly down. Press, lengthen. Keep some of the length as you lift. The trick is not to hinge into the low back. And slowly, slowly, slowly down. So you're keeping a little bit active in between here. You're going to stay in the middle of the kneecaps. And now press, lengthen, lift in the legs and add the upper body. And you'll hear my voice change as I move away from the floor and slowly down. Press, lengthen, lift, floating the lower and the upper. And slowly, 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 slowly down. Two more. Press, lengthen, add ease in the effort. Noticing what glides short and what glides long. And then letting it go on the bottom, particularly in the spine. So you're keeping the legs just a little bit active in between here, but focus on the spine really melting at the bottom. And then when you come down the next time, let everything go. So let the legs flop. And when you're ready, push yourself back into child and just organize yourself in child, however you want to be. This kind of graciousness of flexion. From your child, roll yourself up to sit. And then come forward into tabletop. So hands and knees. Nice and neutral in the spine. And we're going to slide one leg along the floor. So I literally am keeping contact. Let me show you on the closer leg. Contact with the leg before it lifts. And then slide down. And maybe let's just practice that to start. Sliding the leg out. Just to the height of the hip. And then slide back down. And as you do this, how is the leg an extension of your spine? How does your leg connect to your spine? And then when you slide out the next time, staying there for a moment, drawing the knee towards the chest, tucking the toe under and rounding. So crouching kitten, if you know the movement, sliding the leg long, knee moves towards the chest, toe tucks under and round. And looking for this shortening of the back body as you lengthen the leg and then lengthening of that whole chain as you round. It's just such a gorgeous movement to demonstrate the continuity of your whole back body lengthening. And rounding. One more on this first side. What can you feel about the conversation you have with all the parts? Both in the extension and the flexion. Changing sides, you'll see the foot position on this second side a little bit more easily if you don't know this pose. So halfway between the knee and the opposite ankle, approximately. And each of you will find a foot position for you that feels appropriate. Curling the nose towards the knee or the head towards the tail as you round. It really is a movement of flexion. And then pause again. Back in your tabletop and just shift the weight a little bit right, left. And then shift the weight a little bit forward and back. And then when you're ready, take an easy downward facing dog. So just for a moment, a little bit of spiraling. You might want to bend the knees. What again would feel pleasurable, appropriate. Your body, your structure. And then come back down. Bring yourself for a moment back onto your back again. And you're going to have one long leg one more time and one bent knee. I'll swap around so you can see a little bit more easily. So here we are into lengthening in the front body again and lengthening some of the muscles that connect the spine with the legs. So including your psoas. The foot of the bent leg, I'm going to push the foot, reach the knee, and roll the body. And then slowly, slowly come back. Push the foot, reach the knee, roll the body, and then unfurl myself back out of that again. And the long leg side is just receiving the weight. So it's really common for people to brace the long leg or kind of push themselves up off the floor with the long leg. See if you can resist that. And just let it be heavy, surrendering, receiving. And as you push the foot and reach the right leg, in this case, forward, could you press the right shoulder blade back? And if you've got your left leg bent, just do the opposite. So it's push the foot, reach the knee, roll the body, press the shoulder blade back, like you do in walking. And then slowly release all the way back. Push the foot, reach the knee, roll the body, press the shoulder blade, and then unfurl. One more, and as you do this next one, noticing the space at the front of the groin. What gets created as you push and reach? And then slowly, slowly release. Let both sides of the pelvis land A little bit of weight and ground for a moment. And then change your sides. So you might need to vary where you place your foot in order to get an optimum sense of being able to reach. It's a little bit of body proportion thing. So feel free to try it out for size. Same idea. Push, reach, roll. And at some point, if it's interesting for you, pressing the shoulder blade of the same side back. Inviting again a sense of your inherent fluidity to sort of come to the surface. I quite like to imagine that I divide my body in two here, and as the left side of the body, the bent side, is full of water, and as I push and reach, all the water pours into the long side. That can often help ground the long side a little bit more. Just receiving, giving weight and receiving support in this moment-to-moment way. One more, again, noticing the space in the front hip, front groin. Feeling for the weight of the pelvis as you come down, slide both legs long for a moment, just settle into that. This gloriousness of the floor and feeling the floor, really back to this idea again and again, giving weight, receiving support. So it's this two-way process. You've got to give. And you have to receive. And as and when you're ready, bend the knees into constructive rest again. And we're going to take a rolling bridge. So inhale to arch, exhale to curl, lifting the pelvis off just a little bit. And then back down. Inhale to arch, exhale to curl, lifting the pelvis off just 2 inches. Back down. Or a couple of centimeters at a time if you're a centimeter person. And then keep adding a little bit more. And if you're someone that likes something to squeeze here for your adductors, then by all means add a ball or a block or a cushion. And letting the movement up be as interesting as the movement down, and vice versa. So this smooth, calibrated movement. And you might be grounding into your feet or reaching your knees or reaching your tail or grounding into your shoulder blades. There's 100 other things you could do here. So notice what gives you most support, most fluidity. And then when you get up there the next time, wherever you're at, pause there. Have your arms down by your sides. And as you lower the body now, raise the two arms up overhead to the floor. And now come all the way up into a full bridge, whatever your expression of it is, and bring the arms back down by your sides. So it's a moving bridge with alternating arms. I like to inhale on my way back down as the arms are coming up overhead. And exhale on effort as I travel up into the bridge, but you might find another breathing pattern that works for you. Just do something rhythmic with the breath. Couple more passes, keep it super, super easy. You really do want to stay in the realm of easy in somatics. And easy doesn't mean that it's not challenging for the brain. It simply means that we're not overstraining in ways or areas that we shouldn't be. We're doing things that we don't really have the skill to do. And slowly, slowly release down. Decide what you need to do after that movement. So whether it's a twist or a knees to chest or a circle. And then take the knees in towards the chest for a moment, and we're going to roll to the side to sit and then come back down again. So I'm going to roll to one side, go down in the pelvis to come up, and then I'm going to reverse. I'm going to roll to the opposite side, go down into the pelvis to come up. Do that a few times, down to go up. Just finding a rhythm. Something that feels sustaining. And then the next time you're up, grab your blankets or your cushion or whatever it is you're going to put underneath your head in sideline. And I'm going to invite you to come down onto your left-hand side. So you're coming knee over knee, foot over foot, head on your blanket, head to tail as aligned as it can be. Bottom hand can be free. Top hand is going to go onto your top pelvic half. And as you inhale, you're going to lengthen your top pelvic half away from the armpit. And as you exhale, you're going to let it settle back. Inhale, top pelvic half moves that direction away from the armpit. Exhale, you're going to let that settle. So if you put your breath in your upper side body, it really helps here. You might be using the top hand to give you a little bit of directionality, but really the breath is primary to finding the length. And as you breathe out the next time, pivoting on the knee to lift the top foot, And then slowly, slowly releasing. I'm smiling because that word pivoting is so used now since the beginning of the Great Pause. We talk about businesses pivoting and individuals pivoting. Here we are pivoting on our knees. Slowly, slowly release. One more. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale. Lifting up, feeling into everything that gets short. And there's a whole bunch of things that do. And then slowly, 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 slowly release. Take your top arm now and lay it alongside your body. And as you inhale next, take the top arm all the way up over your head. I'm only going to go halfway. So you're going to take your top arm up in line with your ear. And as you exhale, bring your arm back and just do that. Inhale, take the arm overhead all the way up in line with the ear. So don't do what I'm doing. And exhale. Come back. Do that a few times. Inhale. Finding space in your top ribs now. Exhaling, coming back. Inhale. And as you exhale the next time, go down into your bottom ribs. Come up with your head and your foot. And then slowly, slowly release. Take the arm all the way up, over in line with the ear. Inhaling, two more. Exhale, go down into your bottom ribs. Pivot on the knee, side bend. And then slowly, slowly, slowly release. Last one. Inhale, make a count. Exhale. It's a side bend. Slowly, 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 slowly release. And then just place your top hand back on your bottom hand for a moment. Roll yourself back onto your back. Take out the support from underneath the head if it's not comfortable. And legs long or knees bent. Pause here for a moment. And appreciate your breath to the right of your midline and to the left of your midline. And then when you're ready, roll yourself onto your second side, which is your right side. We're going to take the whole sequence on that side. And it can be nice to place the hand on the pelvic half to start. So knee over knee, foot over foot, left hand on the pelvic half. And as you inhale, finding a little bit of length. And as you exhale, letting that length settle. And do that a few times, just as you did on the first side. Inhaling, finding length. Exhaling, letting that length settle. And sensing, feeling, guesstimating as you do this, whether this side is more willing to play or less willing to play. And we all have a tighter side. It's just how we are. Adding in the foot, lifting in your own time so you get a little bit more of gliding short. which then allows you more scope for your gliding long. And then resting in with the lower body, taking the top arm now on the inhale all the way up in line with the ear. And on the exhale, back down onto the side of the body. So you're finding lots of yummy space in the side of the ribs, side of the armpit, side waist, all the way back down. And for most people, it feels more natural to inhale on the expanding phase. But if that's not you, then find another breath rhythm. And then when you're ready, inhaling all the way up. And as you exhale and come back down, now side bend and make your side bend even more side bendy by lifting your top foot. And then slowly, slowly, slowly release out. Inhaling. Exhaling into your side bend. Slowly, 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 slowly releasing. At some point, let that become an inhale or another breath rhythm if it's appropriate, more appropriate for you. Exhale into your side bend. Good. Do two more now in your own rhythm. So what feels most appropriate to you? And whenever you finish your second one, roll yourself back onto your back again. Take the blanket out from underneath your head and just pause. Notice your breath. Get a sense of your midline and how your breath is expressed to the right and the left of that midline. Okay, we're going to do two more movements. Back onto the backs again. Going to take the right knee over the left. And we're going to take the left arm into cactus or stick 'em up. So it's not straight out. The elbow is straight out from the shoulder, but then I bend. So if you can't bring your hand to the floor here, you could find another angle that would work, or you could also put a ball or something underneath this hand. We're going to take this in two stages. First stage, I'm just going to do the knees, inhaling to the right and exhaling back to center. You can join me in this as soon as you have yourself set up. Inhaling knees to the right, staying with that, this idea of being on the bones. Exhaling back to center. So because you have the extra weight of the top leg, you may need to use a little bit of abdominal tone to bring yourself back, particularly if you take the knees sort of further than the bones can handle. Back to center. And now as the knee travels over to the right, the knees, turn to the left, reach the left fingers long into this Y or diagonal shape. And as the knees come back, slide the elbow back to home. So it's what's called a reach and twist. Turn, look at the fingers, reach the fingers long, twisting in the spine, letting the knees do their thing. And then everything, just a little bit like flower, comes back to the midline at the same time. Inhaling long, reaching, twisting. Exhaling back to center. One more. Inhale long. You're never disconnecting the parts of you from the whole. Exhaling back to center. And then swap out. So you have your left leg on top, right arm up in stick'em up, or in another version that will work for you. Knees to the left now, and back to center. Do that a few times. Knees to the left, and back to center. So it's a little bit like the sacroiliac rocking we did at the beginning, except you have a crossed leg. Knees to the left. Back to center. I really encourage you to not take the knees too far here. And then as the knees go left, the next time turning to the right, reaching the right fingers on the Y, and then back to center. So add in those two movements, the reach, the twist, and the movement back to center. Another couple of times. Reach, twist, moving away from your midline. And then as you come back, you're really finding the midline again. It's not that we ever lose it. It stays as this place of orientation. But you're consciously clocking it as you come back. One more. Reach and twist. And back to center. Good. Uncrossing your top leg now. Slide both arms back down to a more neutral position. Go back to a little bit of arch and flatten. If you'd like to put a block or a ball between your knees, you could, or between your thighs. But consciously organize around midline now. Whatever that word means to you. Whatever you conceive of as the middle of you that might bisect right, left, and front, back. Letting the whole spine go along for the ride. And then take a moment and see, is there anything else that you need to do for you before we pause? It might be a reaching, a rolling, a twisting, a turning, a yawning, or nothing. And if you're a teacher, it can be really handy and respectful to hand a little bit of your class over to your students so that they can free form and free play. So take a minute now to move in any way you wish. Explore anything you like. And just enjoy it, whatever you do, just enjoy. And as and when you're ready, we'll move towards Shavasana, your Shavasana, whatever that shape is for you. Grounding yourself in yourself. In all of the precious resources that are in you. Letting your breath flow through your body. Floating your bones. Animating your tissues. Letting your body find the ground. And also orient to space. So that you are indeed this sort of conduit between heaven and earth, right here in your human form. Noticing whatever you wish to notice, and then even letting awareness be. So you might arrive into your own beingness. And resting there, whatever that feels like to you. Taking the breath in a little more deeply now. And as it travels into the body, sending it to your fingers and your toes, to your head and your tail. Making a little movement there as a breath arrives. And then finding a way to reach, to roll. Finding a pace to transition that feels kind. When you're ready, making your way up to sit. Bringing the hands onto the heart. Close your eyes and just sense into the feel of your heartbeat. The expression of your heart in your hands. And take a moment to be oh so grateful for this precious breathing body that you have been given. With all of the wondrous things that it can do and feel. So three more breaths here, just in and around the heart space. And then keeping the energy of the heart in the hands, bringing the hands together. Wishing each other namaste. I greet the God within each and every one of you.